Starting with item 26.
Vayomer Elokim, Yei Rakia betoch ha-mayim.
And God said, quote, "Let there be an expanse in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." End quote. And God made the expanse and separated the waters that were under the expanse from the waters that were above the expanse. And it was so. And God called the expanse heaven. And there was evening and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. I don't see questions yet. I think people are still immersed in what we discussed before. Read again. Again, excerpt 26. And God said, "Let there be an expanse in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." And God made the expanse and separated the waters that were under the expanse from the waters that were above the expanse. And it was so. And God called the expanse heaven. And there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good.
And 27 continues, but not from the Torah, from Urbash.
Urbash, excerpt 27. It is written in the Zohar, Bereshit, quote, "Let the water under the heavens gather into one place, and let the dry land be seen." Let the water gather is the Torah, which is called water. Onto one place means Israel. It is also written, quote, "Let the water gather onto one place," end quote, where water means Torah, and one place means Israel, the recipients of the Torah. Conversely, the nations of the world did not wish to receive the Torah. Hence, the land remained desolate and dry. The Torah is the settling of the world, and in it it exists. The nations of the world who did not receive it remained desolate and dry.
So there's a clear difference here between the will to receive with the Masach, with the intention to bestow, which is called Yeshal Kel. And so there's Masach of Yud, so they discover their direct light, which is the revelation of the Creator. Then there's connection between them. This is called the reception of the Torah by those who yearn in order to bestow. And those who don't, they are then outside the Torah, outside the revelation of the upper light, the revelation of the Creator. And in the meantime, they are in darkness. But bit by bit, all of us are advancing to this state where we are in connection between us and the Creator. And so everyone, as it says, everyone knows me from the greatest to the littlest. My house shall be a house of prayer for all nations, and all nations shall stream unto him. Meaning, everyone comes to the revelation of the Creator within them according to their correction. And we need to make that happen, both for ourselves and for others.